tolerances typically have an inverse relationship with manufacturing cost, as tighter tolerances tend to be more challenging and costly to achieve. Therefore, how can we reduce cost and improve quality in tolerance settings? Yo, what's up guys? It's your boy Chris from WayKen Rapid Manufacturing Channel. Today we're gonna talk about a sweet way to save some cash without sacrificing quality. Tolerance relaxation. So let's get into it. This might sound crazy, but improving quality by loosening tolerances can actually be a smart move. When you tighten the tolerances, cost go up and the chance of rejection increase too. So from a cost standpoint, we actually want tolerances to be on the larger side. Sometimes engineering thinking that assigning super tight tolerances is gonna make their parts top notch. But that's just plain wrong. It actually ends up costing more and increasing the likelihood of rejections. When it comes to component tolerances, we gotta think about how parts fit together, what the parts have to do, and how the parts are manufactured. If you need to save some cash on manufacturing cost without sacrificing part quality, check out these 5 ways to loosen tolerances. 1. Take a second look at the functional requirements of the part to see which tolerances are really necessary. 2. Work with your suppliers and manufacturers to figure out which is the tolerance can be loosened up without affecting the quality of product. 3. Invest in a better production equipment and tools to make sure you are hitting those tolerances. 4. Optimize the design of the part to make it less sensitive to changes in tolerances. 5. Test the tolerances under real-world conditions to see which one can be relaxed without any issues. If you want to get a handle on some tricky dimensions, you can ask your suppliers and manufacturers about it. It's super important to do this, because you are not likely to find this info on your own. Manufacturers might reject your production because they are limited by tolerances that are too tight. You may not see their internal rejection reports, but you will definitely feel the burn from the cost associated with their rejections. So it's better to ask upfront and avoid these issues altogether. Obviously, we also need top-notch equipment to test and guarantee that these tolerances are met. So what we need to do is to set a tolerance that controls the size, ensuring that the part functions correctly when it's assembled or in its final operating conditions. Alright, now we know what's good to go. We'll talk about other ways to save money and boost quality next time. This is a wrap for today, folks. Thanks for tuning in. This is Chris signing off. If you like this video, hit that subscribe button and give us thumbs up. Catch you later.